Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Movie Wrap-Up, and I'm Renee Twiddle. So, the end of Road Trip is the beginning of The Coverup, and today's episode is called The Coverup, and it's the next movie in the movie series, and it's episode 9. And after it shows the end of the road trip, it goes to the next morning at the apartment complex, and Melissa is waiting for Natasha to pick her up from the apartment complex. And then it shows Natasha waking up, and she realizes it all happened. She goes into the bathroom, and Sarah is found dead. Natasha walks out of the bathroom, and she sees flashes of Kelly and Tanya. And she realizes she was right, and that Kelly is really Tanya, and Tanya had alternate, like, identity as Kelly. And Tanya says she had to kill Sarah because Sarah knew too much. Which was kind of vague because you didn't really know anything. Like, did Sarah really know anything? But according to Tanya, she knew too much. I just think that Tanya just killed Sarah she didn't want to be Kelly anymore. Because Kelly was kind of dumb. After she realizes that it's Tanya, she runs into the guest room. She grabs her phone underneath the bed, and she's calling Melissa. And Melissa's at the apartment complex. She's, like, fixing her hair, and her phone tells her who's calling, and she's like, finally, Natasha. So she's walking over to the phone. She picks it up, and at this moment, Tanya has started to strangle Natasha with a belt. So Natasha's, like, freaking out, trying to get Melissa to hear her, and Melissa's like, is this some kind of joke? This is not funny. She's picking me up from the apartment complex, like, because she's, like, sick of being there. Like, it's abandoned. Melissa hangs up the phone because she's annoyed with Natasha. And then Natasha finally stops squirming and she dies. Claudia and Jade are on the road, and Claudia is drunk driving. Claudia hits someone with her car, and Jade discovers that he is dead. And this is what happens. Jade cannot recognize that it was her cousin, Blake. And Blake was in Friends to the End and The Road Trip, the end of the movie. And so she couldn't recognize that it was him because the car damaged his face. Claudia thinks they should just drive away, and then Claudia tells Jade to hide the body. All Jade does is just drag the body, like, over to the side. Right after Jade moves Blake's body out of the way, it cuts the next day. This scene should have happened before the car accident, but it didn't happen. So Detective Roberts discovers Kelly's body, but it doesn't show Kelly, like, get up or anything. This movie has some errors in it, and it just doesn't make any sense to me. So Detective Roberts discovers Kelly's body, and then the other Renee's body, the trailer trash version of Renee. And Claudia's stressed about the day before when she got in a car accident, and Jade thinks someone should kill her, and that she is stupid, and they get into a disagreement. Claudia imagines killing Jade. They argue about what happened. And it shows Blake show up at Detective Roberts' crime scene, which he discovers that his friends are murdered. This should have happened before the car accident, but it didn't. So this movie is all messed up. So this happened right before he died, but it kind of looks like a flashback, because right when Blake opens the door, there's, like, bright white light, and usually that indicates, like, a flashback. So, and it was only the sun, but whatever. Claudia calls Tanya for help to cover up what she did. This scene should have happened right after Tanya killed Natasha, because she's there, and Detective Roberts was already there, and it's, like, it's so confusing. This movie is so, like, messed up. Like, it just irritates the hell out of me. And Tanya reconciles with Joe to help her with Claudia's plan. Tanya says she'll kill Joe if he ever tries to kill her again. Tanya informs Joe what has to be done. The next day, Jade is about to get to the police station, but Joe abducts her. Jade easily escapes. Joe finds Jade missing, so he goes back, because he said he was going to go tie her up, and he comes back and he's like, okay, cunt, I'm going to tie you up, and she's missing. She just ran off, left, and escaped. It was very easy. The garage door was open. Joe freaks out and tells Tanya Jade escaped, and Tanya was, like, hitting plants with like a stick, and usually Joe is like chopping stuff always, and it never even it's explained why in the series he is chopping stuff. So Tanya goes to go find Jade. Joe calls Claudia to meet up with her. Joe meets up with Claudia and then he strangles her to death because he's tired of her shit. Tanya is still looking for Jade. Renee tells Detective Roberts, I tell Detective Roberts, the whole story of what happened at the apartment complex and what happened after that with Savannah Cooper. And then Renee says she's going to join a group for support for victims, and then she leaves. Melissa is shown walking. She waited for Natasha too long, and now she's left on her own. So Melissa left the apartment complex, and she ended up walking, and she discovers Blake's body. So here it happens, and another error in this movie, the three times you see Blake in this movie, he has three different outfits on. This movie's so screwed up, I wish it was better. I mean, it's a good movie, but it's just like everything is jumbled and it doesn't make any sense. And then Janitor Sykes is approaching in the background behind Melissa, and he stops, stabs at the camera, and then it cliffhangers. That is it for episode 9, The Coverup. Kind of a dysfunctional movie, and I'm hoping you guys understand now what the movie was about. And I chose a song, Miss Murder by AFI, and this was in the beginning and end credits, and I'm not going to be lip-syncing. Unfortunately, my mother is going to be lip-syncing because mostly the movie was about her covering up a murder and all that stuff, like, so it's mostly about her. No wonder why the movie's screwed up, because she's in it. Anyway, I'm going to go have her lip-sync the song, and then I'll close the show afterwards.
Thank you.
Okay, time to close this stupid, annoying episode. I wish that the movie was better constructed, but it was a rush job just to conclude and tie up loose ends of the previous two movies. Anyway, I'm Renee Twiddle, and this Wednesday is the series finale of Movie Wrap-Up. We're going to give you some a little bit of teasers and previews for the final movie, which is going to be out sometime in April. Thank you for watching. I'm Renee Twiddle, and I'll see you next time.